famous for being Britain's first home to a well-known takeaway restaurant, which opened its doors to chicken lovers back in 1965. Adverse to entertain was ex-nightclub owner Nigel Evans, who laid on a night of Hollywood bling. And it proved an opening night sensation, as Nigel scored a very healthy 32 out of 40. Today, it's the turn of catering manager Valerie Holliday, who's confident she has what it takes to clinch top spot on the leaderboard.
I'm going to do the best I can tonight to make people adore me and enjoy my food.
How can anyone fail to adore you, Val? Tomorrow's host is Gift of the Gab carpet store manager Bernard Dorset, a man who clearly also does a good line in matching shirts.
If I don't win this competition based on the fact that my food is my heart, my passion, I will be disappointed with that.
Then on Thursday, pneumatic nail shop owner Dawn Barry will try and grab her chance to wow the group.
I think my strengths lie more as a host than a cook, i.e. the entertainment side, but I still think my cook is all right.
Before bread salesman Paul Morris brings the week to an end by hosting the Last Supper.
I'm here to win, really. I want to win it, I really do. And I think the other guys are here to take part and then win it as a second.
Well, they'll all have their work cut out to better Nigel, who impressed with his glitzy party and glamorous showbiz connections.
I was, like, really, like, in awe of how bling it really was.
Oh,
my goodness me! Danny LaRue, Babs, Barbara Windsor, Bruce Forsyth, and I'm going, wow, this guy knows people. I only know the window cleaner.
Cheers.
My thoughts on the group were just amazing. I couldn't believe every time somebody walked through the door how great it was. Like, we'd known each other for weeks. It was really uncanny.
Oh, it's Bubble and Squeak, love it.
But not everyone got on, as a frustrated Bernard got upset with Dawn and Nigel for stealing centre stage.
This time, us three went and left the two guys alone because we might as well not be here.
Why?
Why Bernard kicked off, I don't really know, to be honest with you. I don't know. It was sort of 1 minute, it was just bang, and that was it, like a firework, and it just went off.
There's no one else in this room, as far as I'm concerned. It's just you and Nigel.
And in particular, he feels it's Dawn that's hogging the limelight.
The issue I had with Dawn last night was to do with Dawn is a person who is me, myself, and I. And there's nobody else in the room or the house or the universe apart from Dawn. It's Dawn, Dawn, and Dawn.
I was probably jealous because we were having a good laugh and he thought it had been left out. But we can't talk to everyone at the same time all night, can you?
I think Bernard would like to be the centre of attraction.
I just think it was just him saying, look, me, I'm still here. People need to pay a bit more attention to me. So I think he needs to be in the limelight constantly.
So the ball's in Bernard's court to prevent a growing rift with Dawn.
I think Bernard just got to apologise, and Dawn will be fine straight away after that, immediately.
I won't allow Dawn tonight or the rest of the nights to split this group. She's not worthy of splitting the group into segments.
Oh dear, looks like Val will have a tough job keeping the peace among her guests. But she's a practiced dinner party host, and she's sure she can produce a night to remember.
I'm going to do the best that I possibly can to enable people to have a wonderful evening. It's about being a good host and good food. One without the other is no good. It can be good food, but people can be bored out of their brains.
Well, hopefully her guests won't find her dessert too dull and boring. Creamy puff pastry fruit slice, a time-honoured classic.
It's not really into a lot of fruit in the cooking, so a bit disappointed with that.
Doesn't really slot in anywhere. It's puff pastry with fruit.
Hardly rave reviews. But Val is more than confident that this tried and tested pudding will be a big hit with her doubting diners.
I'm doing this dessert tonight because I've done it millions of times in the post, and sometimes in these sort of things, it's best to say what you're good at. So that's what I'm doing.
Very wise. Having rolled out a packet of puff pastry, she cooks it in the oven for 20 minutes before taking it out to cool. Next, Val turns her attention to the main course, Lancashire pheasant wrapped in streaky bacon with game chips and roasted Mediterranean vegetables.
Oh, that sounds like a bit of stodge soup there. That'd be all right.
It's a risky dish, that, being pheasant, and you must know what you're doing.
I've actually never had pheasant before in my life, so I'm going to taste it, but I don't know if it might go in my head go through me a bit like eating a pheasant. I don't know, because you see them running around. You see chickens running around. That just sounds silly, doesn't it? But
it does rather, yes. Still, you should be in safe hands, as pheasant is another dish Val's been cooking for years. And to ensure she has the freshest pheasants possible, she's visiting her local game farm.
Oh, hello, Rich. Nice to see you. I've come to collect my pheasants.
Right. You'll really impress your guests with those.
I hope you're right. I hope they like pheasant.
Blow them away, as they say.
I like pheasant.
And how are we actually cooking them? What are you doing?
I'm going to roast them with streaky bacon.
Slow roast? How long?
For about an hour.
I do think that's quite a while, because these are young birds. They're very tender.
Well, yeah. I'm going to keep basting them, and I'm going to keep my eye on them.
Really keep your eye on them?
I'm not going to question
your judgment.
No, I'll just keep my eye on them. When I think they're done, I'm just going to... I've never timed anything in my life. And I'll just go by instinct. When I think they're done, then I'll take them out of the oven, because I'm out to impress tonight.
Yeah, really show them, are you?
Yeah.
I hope you do.
Having seemingly ignored all the advice on how to roast the pheasants, Val returns home to prepare her starter, Jumbo King Prawn Mornay, another classic from her dinner party repertoire.
That's me. That is what I think a starter should be about.
I honestly have no idea what a mornay is, so I'm just thinking it might just be a medley of just like the king prawns and a few like tomatoes or something in there, and honestly I have no idea.
I do like normal prawns, I do eat normal prawns, but king prawns, if they've got the eyes and all that on, no, I won't be able to do that. She might chop some off their face, let's hope so.
Might be funnier if she hasn't. Val begins her starter by piping, or rather forking, mashed potato around the rim of the scallop shells she'll serve the prawns in.
The great thing about these shells is once you get them from the fishmonger and you pay, I can't even remember how much I paid now, you can put them in the dishwasher and wash them time after time.
Back in the 70s? Having prepped the shells, she starts to make the mornay sauce by heating up some milk with salt, pepper and butter. And while she waits for it to boil, she mixes corn flour with some more milk.
It's a yummy dish if you like prawns and cheese and what have you, but it always goes down well wherever I've done dinners.
Next, she adds the cornflour mixture to the boiling milk.
I don't want to get it too thick. I would do it slightly thicker if I was doing a cauliflower cheese sauce, but I'm not. I'm doing a mornay. Now I'm going to add some mature grated cheese to enhance the flavour.
And as she stirs away, Val's thoughts drift off to the £1,000 prize.
The only reason I'm doing this is because I want the money. I want to go out on Saturday and shop till I drop with £1,000 in £20 notes. I love people, don't get me wrong, and I know I'm good at cooking. But I still want the £1,000 to go and spend and buy nice things.
You could start by buying some bowls, Val, instead of using washed-up old shells. With the mornay sauce now complete, Val spoons the dawn-friendly headless prawns into the shells before smothering them in cheese sauce. She then adds more grated cheese for the topping.
If I don't put that cheese on, it won't brown under the grill. And the appearance of it, which is frightfully important to me, will brown with that.
The starter is now prepped and ready to go in the oven 10 minutes before serving. And with the pastry for her dessert now cool, Val spreads whipped cream across the bottom layer. She then adds strawberries and kiwi fruit, the top layer of pastry, before sprinkling on icing sugar as a finishing touch. And with everything running like clockwork, Val has no doubt her guests are in for a good night.
My friends think it's pretty wonderful to come round to my house for dinner, because they know they're going to have a good night, because my friends adore me and they like my cooking.
Lucky old friends. Finally, Val prepares the pheasants by wrapping them in streaky bacon.
So you have to do it. You're protecting the bird so it doesn't dry out. So you're keeping the juices in, because the bacon, the juices that come from the bacon, the fat, will keep the pheasant moist so that it will be tender and succulent, really.
Val then adds some water before covering the birds in tin foil and putting them into the oven.
I will keep basting them, and hopefully in 45 minutes to an hour they'll be ready. Hopefully.
But Val, isn't this all a bit early? You're not serving them for another 3 hours. Meanwhile, she serves up an early dinner, then dolls herself up in... Catering manager Valerie Holliday is putting all her cooking skills to use in a competition to be best host and win a £1,000 prize.
Just give me the bottle, that'll be all right.
And with the party already in full swing, Val heads to the kitchen.
I've taken the pheasants out of the oven and then I've cut them in half.
To keep them warm until serving, Val uses her hostess trolley.
I'm putting it in the hostess trolley simply because it won't dry it the same as an oven would. The oven would start cooking it again, where this is just keeping it at a certain temperature.
Well, let's hope so. Your butcher did warn you about overcooking them. And while Val puts her starter into the oven to cook, Bernard still can't believe his luck.
I'm very shocked that Valerie lives in the location she does, because she's virtually my neighbour. When I run out of wine and gin, I'll be around here every night. Well, every other night. But she don't know that yet.
Lucky her.
And it's not just Bernard who's surprised where Val lives.
I thought it'd be down a long beaten track on its own in the middle of nowhere.
I did think I might have to put wellies on to get out.
Well, yeah, that's what I meant. Somewhere like in the middle of a farm or something like that. But it's lovely, isn't it?
I think she's great. I think it's cosy.
I'm really quite surprised where Val lives. Yeah. I really am. I thought she'd be in a real nice bit of Preston.
You're winding me up. You're winding me up.
I'm just saying that you look at Val, she's quite a posh person. She's very refined. And then...
I think you're a naughty boy.
Absolutely.
You're a naughty boy. Do you know what I mean?
Maybe we should just start eating before things get out of hand. First up, Val serving jumbo king prawn mornay.
Oh my goodness, wow, this looks fab.
Does it?
Yeah, it looks it.
Thank you very much.
That is stunning, yeah, it is.
Oh my god, that's good.
That is.
I need your recipe.
Do you?
Yeah, you're going to put it on thingy, is it Channel 4 website?
How does it go on there? Cook.
Yep, that's the place you'll find all of Val's recipes.
I started the mornay. I'd never had a mornay before, didn't know what it was. So when it turned up, I was pleasantly surprised. It was beautiful, absolutely fantastic. Well cooked, very tasty, spot on.
She put mashed potatoes in there, which I love. The king prawns, I was dreading them having eyes and heads and having to snap them off and squirt. And everyone was like, oh, but when it came, oh.
Val, I'd like to toast. What a fabulous talk.
Here, here.
Fantastic.
Here, here.
Oh,
Val.
Fabulous.
Thanks, Val.
Well, they enjoyed it. They loved it. So that makes me happy. It was worth all the stress. And now I've got to get through my pheasant. Haven't I? If they love my pheasant, I'm there.
Well, fingers crossed. Val's final bit of prep is to pan-fry thin potato slices in oil.
See, that's too hot.
She's making game chips, which are a classic accompaniment to pheasant.
Sometimes I cheat and I use Walker's crisps.
Oh, Val, you little minx. Finally, it's the moment of truth for the pheasant. So what's the verdict?
Superb. It's looking good because it's moist. It looks succulent and not dried out. If it was dried out, I'd be embarrassed, but it's not.
Time to find out if your guests agree as Val serves Lancashire pheasant with game chips.
Oh, Val.
I hope Val. You like pheasant.
You're excelling yourself. Thank you.
Do you like pheasant? I didn't ask you about it.
Do you know, I've only ever had it once. Other than that, I was a virgin before then.
Were you? How do you like the pheasant?
I've only had one taste up to now.
And?
Don't know yet. You're a good cook, whatever. Even if I don't like the taste or something, it doesn't matter, does it?
Thank you, darling.
The main course, I was really looking forward to the pheasant, and it was so disappointing. It was unbelievable. Had no taste in it. It was dry. Just not what I was expecting at all. It was terrible.
I couldn't touch it. I thought it was quite tough. I think there was too much of it. It was like half a bird.
I was a bit apprehensive about having it because I had this vision and everyone thought it was funny of a pheasant running across in the street and I thought, I can't eat it. It's like a little baby rabbit or a hamster or something. And,
yeah, mind you, there are far worse things you could be eating.
You want to try the alligator?
Oh, my God!
It's gorgeous. I swear, it's like salted chicken.
I was in Cambodia and we went to this fabulous outdoor restaurant and there was a tank full of scorpions. And half of them were dead because they all suffocated each other. So, not to disrespect them, I had the whole of the scorpion and the body in. I thought,
God.
So you can actually pick your own scorpion at the same
time? Yeah, you could do, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Like a fish tank full of scorpions.
I'm puke.
Yeah. But that's when it rolled, isn't it?
I'm going to throw up. That's horrible. Let me out.
It was lovely, though.
They were lovely. Trust me.
I get worried about your white carpet.
Dawn, are you okay?
That was horrible. How can you talk about that? Oh, God.
Stuff we get a stitch of it, the old boy.
Dawn, I'll crawl again.